Welcome, everybody, and thank you so much for coming. So we're going to just start, as we do always, that wonderful opportunity we have to open our hearts and send love and gratitude to our beloved Earth. Let's take some slow, deep breaths to get into that peaceful, receptive state. So we breathe in slowly and deeply. We hold our breath. We breathe out, then we hold our breath. Let's do that for a few more breaths. Now let's listen for our heartbeat, which is a pulse of light coming down through the silver cord from our mighty iron presence, anchoring in our heart, giving us life. Let's just see and feel and bless that heartbeat. That heartbeat that anchors into that beautiful threefold flame, which is the anchorage of our mighty I Am presence within our physical bodies. Let's just connect with that beautiful flame as we sit in that expanded golden flame in the center, golden yellow flame of wisdom and illumination, perception and discrimination. We see our bodies in this beautiful, dazzling golden flame. To the right, we can see the pink flame, that glorious, dazzling pink flame of pure divine love. And then we see to the left of us that beautiful expanded flame, that sapphire blue, bringing into us the feeling of the will, the power, the faith, and the protection from our mighty I Am presence. See and feel and bless this glorious light. Let's take our awareness now up through the top of our head, through the silver cord, to our mighty beloved I Am presence. Let's see this glorious, all-powerful, all-knowing, all-loving presence smiling down on us. Our wonderful presence of God, I Am. And now we see in the center of our chest a beautiful golden sun forming, dazzling and brilliant like the noonday sun, the beautiful focus of light from our I Am presence. Open our hearts and send love and gratitude to our mighty I Am presence for beating our heart and giving us life. And now we see those rays from our beautiful sun in the center of our chest, dazzling and brilliant, billions and billions of rays going forth and connecting up with each and every miniature sun in all the cells of our bodies, our four earthly bodies, all those little inner workers receiving this expanded light. Let's feel the joy, the happiness, and the gratitude of each and every little inner worker of our four earthly bodies. Sense and see and feel that wonderful light saturating our earthly bodies. And now let's just fill our feelings with a feeling of love and gratitude. And let's call to the beloved Ascended Masters, beloved Ascended Master David Lloyd, the great God of Gratitude, to fill us, each one and all mankind, with this feeling, that light substance, from the Ascended Master realm of gratitude and love. We see our beautiful suns turning a deep shade of pink with a golden radiance. Gratitude and love for all our many, many blessings. Gratitude and love to the great Ascended Hosts for these marvelous teachings. Gratitude and love for all our loved ones and our friends. Gratitude and love for our homes and our supply. Gratitude and love for all the many, many blessings that we receive daily on our earthly journeys. Gratitude to the great and beloved elemental kingdom, animate and so-called inanimate, the beauty and bounty of nature. God bless, love and thank them, each and every precious one. Gratitude to the beloved angels. And gratitude to all life on our beloved earth. And now we see these rays in this wonderful expanded state, forming a lattice of light, dazzling and brilliant. We see our entire earth folded in this glorious pink and golden light, saturating every part of life on our beloved earth, especially those parts of life that are never loved or thanked, with this wonderful gift, our opportunity of sending love, light, and gratitude to all life. And we just give deep, deep thanks for this.
I was just thinking, Jeanette, would you like to read the opening invocation for us?
Oh, yes, I would love to. Thank you. Before reading the words of a master, we say together with mics muted, as suggested by beloved Lord Kutumi. Beloved presence of God, I am. It is thy life and intelligence that enables me to read and comprehend and absorb that which is required of me. For life, I am so grateful. Beloved Master Kutumi, I ask for your feeling and your capacity to use this instruction for God's glory and mankind's comfort. We thank you. And now, great I Am Presence, take me within thyself. There instruct me and cause me to retain the full memory of these inner instructions. Thank you from beloved Saint Germain.
Marvelous. Thank you so much, beloved Jeanette. All right. So today we're continuing with the magic presence, and Gary's actually reading this week. He's back on track, which is good. And it's about experiencing cosmic light. Just a lovely part of the chapter. And then the video is the Spirit of Hope. And it's just so heart opening from beloved Archangel Gabriel, just really showing the great love that beloved archangels and all the angels have for all of us. And then Terry's going to read Managing the Outer Mind, which is always helpful for us. It's from beloved Holy Aeolus. As we know, he was the former Mahachauhan before he went on to be the Cosmic Holy Spirit, Holy Aeolus. And that's from the Cosmic Library, from the Bridge to Spiritual Freedom. Just some really good pointers there for us. And then I thought I'd continue with on the Spirit of Hope and read from beloved Archie, I hope, from, don't know what happened. I didn't finish writing Gabriel there. Obviously something happened. Anyway, the beloved divine complement of Archangel Gabriel. And then John is actually going to read our decrees for us. So that's just marvelous. And Antoinette, she's busy at the moment with something else, that's come up for her. And so John is going to read, which is just marvelous. He's one of our beloved Chilas from the Good Hope Sanctuary. So we're going to listen to Gary now.
Chapter 11, The Last Chapter of the Magic Presence by Godfre Ray King. The True Messenger of Divine Service, Experiencing Cosmic Light. We arrived at the top of our climb just in time to see a glorious sunset in a very clear atmosphere. In the distance, we could see Mount Everest and the other famous peaks of that glorious range. The majesty, towering presence of these mountains and the mystery of the ages that shrouded their past made us feel a deeper longing than ever to reach the inmost heart of the great eternal wisdom, to feel ourselves a part of it, and to be able to pour forth its blessing to all mankind that it might be happy also. I want you to stay here tonight, said Chananda, and see the sunrise from this particular spot, as it will be many years before we shall see it again in cooperation with a certain cosmic activity that is taking place at this time. It is the first time in 70 years that these two activities occur simultaneously. At 3 o'clock, we rose and mounted our little ponies, which took us still higher up the mountain to a point where we could see the sunrise to best advantage. We reached this place just as its radiance began to grow brighter. In a few seconds, great rays of light of every conceivable color began to shoot into the sky and continued for fully 10 minutes. It was as if the light itself rejoiced in the mighty presence of life. Then as the great golden disk came into view, a quivering, sparkling radiance pierced our flesh and penetrated into the very centers of our bodies. Never before have we experienced any such sensation from sunlight. The vivifying effect lasted for hours, and the glorious feeling, the beauty of the scene left us still floods over me as I recall the experience. One knows after such an occurrence that the mighty master intelligence of the universe is still at the helm and guides the destinies of our earth and humanity, notwithstanding all our outer appearance of chaos to the contrary. You have felt within your bodies, said Chananda, a slight action of mighty cosmic rays which have been directed to earth at the present time by the great cosmic masters who are giving transcendent assistance in this cycle of humanity in its outer struggle. Their outpouring is a radiance of love, courage, and strength to the race which sustains the individual during this period of change and so illumines his inner bodies that it enables the mighty I Am presence to release more of its perfection into and through the outer self. Those of you who are to receive training in the use of these rays will be enabled to focus great streams of light essence and consciously direct them, pouring forth blessings to mankind through great currents of healing power and harmonizing streams of love. Few are ready to be taught how to control and to use these mighty rays, but all for whom it is possible are being prepared now. These great streams of condensed light and pure substance can be drawn, qualified, and sent forth again to produce definite result as easily as a searchlight reveals the scenes it passes over. Come now, we must return and go to the home of the chief of this council of Darjeeling. We went back to our ponies, which took us to Darjeeling, and thence were driven by auto to a beautiful home built upon one of those lovely hills surrounding the city. The grounds were filled with stately trees, and the view over the country that lay before us was one of the most beautiful on earth. We were ushered in and presented to the head of this branch of the Great White Brotherhood.
Thank you. There we get. It's just so marvelous to think of those mighty rays coming, and that we are all being trained, as we know, through our decrees and our projection of the rays to direct these rays through the power of our own presence. That's what it's all about, isn't it? So extraordinary. Now we're going to listen to beloved Archangel Gabriel. And it's also interesting now because it's the time where we submit petitions. In December and June, we submit petitions. And this was actually a petition that Archangel Gabriel submitted, but I'm not sure that he got it, but it was just such a heart-opening, reading from him. It was really just extraordinary. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it. This is an excerpt from beloved Archangel Gabriel from the Bridge to Freedom Journals, Book 2, The Spirit of Hope and the Power of the Resurrection Flame. It was at a time when the Teton retreat was open. Hail to thee, O nature spirits, all who are a part of this magnificent countryside. I, Gabriel, the messenger of the Most High, bring you love from home. It is I, the cosmic angel of resurrection, who has awakened you from sleep each springtime, calling you again to don the festive garments of fragrance and beauty. In earnest and obedient response to my call, you become the magnificence of the resurrection flame, the example to mankind of what can be done by obedience to life. Beloved hearts, the complement of my life stream is known as cosmic being hope. Thus, resurrection and hope move hand in hand across the face of this earth, stirring new life from the ashes of a dead past, the second birth. They bring the divine pattern and plan to remembrance within the nature kingdom, and, without resistance, that kingdom manifests the glory of immortality, springtime after springtime. To those sons and daughters of men who choose to accept my light, my message, and my presence, it is now my privilege and honor to bring the remembrance of the divine image, the Immaculate Conception, held within the mind and the heart of God. That image nestles within the threefold flame, within the physical heart. Let it be as obedient in response to me as are the flowers of the early springtime. As I bring to you tonight remembrance of the homeland, let resurrection and hope stir within you that illumination which makes your spirit rise and throw off the bondage of human thought and feeling. Let resurrection and hope take command of the flesh garment which you occupy, transmute those garments into blazing light, and make each one a son, a daughter of the Most High Living God. Then you shall be crowned with the diamond crown of immortality, carrying the scepter of God dominion and mastery. As you so reveal your master presence, it shall draw all imprisoned life to you, that you in turn may wave the wand of immortality over it and set it free. Beloved ones, tonight I bring you the love of the great archangels. I bring to you the hope of my beloved. Without hope, no life stream would continue to exist. So tonight I ask you to call with me for the angels of hope to breathe upon the hearts and souls of spirits of all those in the realm of limbo, and into the astral and psychic realm, where life streams have been imprisoned for thousands of years. This will help to stir them again from the lethargy which comes from that feeling of hopelessness and helplessness. The wings of hope are outstretched over this entire planet tonight, and her presence is pouring its blessings. As we draw the attention of the Great Karmic Board to the petitions of beloved Serapis Bay, the Brotherhood of Luxor, and myself, as representatives of the resurrected spirit from whence will rise the Ascended One, I ask you to join with us in calling for the raising of the spirit of hope within mankind everywhere, as well as in the elemental kingdom, which seems so antagonistic toward mankind. That elemental kingdom has been forced into destructive thought and feeling forms. Humanly created entities
of such distortion that I would not care to describe them to your consciousness. Those elementals, too, have lost hope. Those who were born to live in the light of the sun, swing freely in the wind, to ride on the clouds, these are now imprisoned in the creations of the astral realm, pressed out of the thought and feeling centers of mankind. Some are compelled to abide in these forms for ages and ages. Tonight we bring new hope to such elemental life so imprisoned. In these petitions, which we are to make tonight, please ask with us for the removal of the magnetic centers within all humanly creative, destructive thought forms. This will automatically allow the imprisoned elementals to release themselves from those forms and rise into the sun for repolarization. Beloved ones, today you stand at the threshold of a new era. Angels and men shall walk along life's pathway together. This is the activity of the seventh ray, and we, the great lords of the angelic host, come to bring this remembrance to you. Now, as we make our petition to the karmic board, would you please arise and join your sweet energies with us in such a petition? Hail to thee, O karmic board, great and mighty dispensers of mercy and justice to our earth. I, Gabriel, Archangel of Resurrection, speak to thee on behalf of the Brotherhood at Luxor, on behalf of beloved Serapis Bay, on behalf of the hope, which is the survival of the spiritual consciousness of mankind. I petition thee, O great and mighty board, to set aside now and forever the dispensation of the old era, wherein death and crucifixion represent the primal impulse toward which the attention of the Christian world has been focused. I ask for the privilege, honor, and opportunity of speaking into the heart of every life stream belonging to this evolution, and to convey to the outer consciousness that the goal of life is the ascension. In the name of God, in the name of life, in the name of all the mankind of earth and the imprisoned elementals, in the name of those angels who have taken human form, I make the call this night for the ascension at the close of this earth life of every soul upon the planet, so that none are forced to return in flesh bodies. I make the call tonight for the right and privilege to take the sword of living flame into the psychic and astral realms and plunge it into the heart of every human created entity that is there, forming the mass effluvia, pressure, and blanket of human creation in which mankind moves. I ask for the privilege of breaking asunder the magnetic pull created by the thought and feeling centers of mankind, which elemental life has been forced to obey. Allow every bit of elemental life within these forms to be free, to be free, to be free. Let them return this instant to the heart of the sun for repolarization. I ask this for every thought form of alcoholism, sex, lust, insanity, and every vicious human creation that has attached itself to any life stream upon the earth. Let me also plunge that living sword into the great overshadowing entities created from the mass thoughts and feelings of mankind, which represent war, plagues, and disease of every kind. These abide over cities, countries, continents, and even the planet itself. In the name of the God of life, I ask you to remove from elemental life tonight the necessity for longer obeying destructive impulses of mankind. Give them their eternal freedom. Let the psychic and astral realms be no more. These realms are but an effluvia of concentrated and imprisoned elemental life. O powers of light, remove tonight the vow of obedience to mankind, which was taken by the elementals in all kindness. In the name of Helios and Vesta and the sun behind the sun, I make this plea. Release elemental life from the necessity of taking on the forms of vicious and destructive thoughts, feelings, and spoken words. Now, O beloved, great, and mighty karmic board, with my own two hands I am willing to strip every one of the 10 billion souls of those humanly created entities which feed upon their life. These forms are created by anger, malice, hatred, gluttony, in fact every one of the deadly sins, as well as the subtle sins too. Give me the freedom so to act. Give me the opportunity to restore them to that freedom which they had before they wove those shadows about themselves. Then you will see that their life will no longer have the struggle with those creations of the past.
So relieved and released from that pressure, their life will give you the light you require for this earth, that which is required to make this dark planet a blazing sun. Powers of light, Kuan Yin, Queen of Mercy, I ask for the earth and these people mercy. I ask this for the earnest shepherds of this activity and for those in orthodox channels as well. All those ministers, priests and rabbis, all good men and women everywhere, give me the authority tonight to bring to these freedom from the karma which they have ignorantly created. Let this be done through the release of my own vital fires. Give me opportunity now to breathe upon the heart flame and resurrect the mastery, powers and faculties which they had in the great central sun before the world was. Let this be done particularly for those who have the memories in the etheric and causal bodies. Let me revivify these memories and powers with such confidence that these beloved ones become masters in works and not in words. Something more than ordinary must be done. To this end, I, Gabriel, Archangel of Resurrection, speak to you on behalf of Lord Michael and all my brothers in the angelic kingdom. To this end, we give our life and shall dedicate whatever energies you ask to make a balance for these life streams. Let us show all mankind what the resurrection flame can do. Let the ascension be an accomplished fact for every soul as he leaves the earth at the close of this embodiment, freed from the karma of the past. In thy name, O God, I have spoken. To thee, great lords, I bow and rest my case, serene in the knowledge whatever thou shalt do will most certainly be in alignment with our endeavors to make this planet shine like the sun. Now, abiding within the state of listening grace, will you remember your friend Gabriel? Know that at any moment, even when you think not, I may be required by the law that you and I stand face to face. Prepare well for that moment, for no man knows when it comes. May you be able to say in that hour that truly you are the servants of the Lord. My love enfolds you, as does my light. Blessings and gratitude for your service. Accept the love of hope, myself, and all the angels of heaven. We thank you.
Oh, really profound from beloved Archangel Gabriel, such a mighty petition. And now, beloved Terry is going to read for us. Thank you, beloved Terry.
You're so welcome. That was very beautiful. Greetings, everyone. Managing the outer mind. There you go. Beloved Holy Aeolus from our cosmic library, an individual's divine plan is preordained and placed in the accounts of the spiritual archives at the time individualization takes place. When the physical body is formed, the Holy Spirit wires it just as is wired an electric sign for illumination. That wire is the breath. And then on the breath, the life principle enters the body. Within the life principle is the divine plan, and the individual who allows that divine plan to expand the perfect master form is fulfilling his divine destiny. When the seed is prepared to give richness to the world of manifest form, a process of germination takes place, and from this seed comes forth the divine plan of the flower, the fruit, the vegetable or tree, and the whole physical world is enriched thereby. There are approximately 10 billion souls belonging to the human race, each one born to enrich the entire universe. For this reason, a tremendous expenditure of light is projected forth from the higher octaves. Many in the course of their earthly careers have enriched the consciousness of humanity and the human race to which they belong. Many other individuals have been using life to create unlike their divine plan. Now, because the hour of harvest is here, the Holy Spirit is required to bring each soul back to the heart of God and show the fruit of his living. That is why I come, and that is why I have remained with each of you, my children. Every emotion, every thought, every word, every quality that makes humanity happier and richer, and life more beautiful for all that lives, is in accord with the divine plan, just as every petal of the full-blown rose is filled with its perfume and adds to its beauty. On the other hand, every habit, thought, word, and feeling that tends to make humankind unhappy and their burden heavier is not in accord with the divine plan. It is simply a misuse of God's harmonious energy, and no one will be held guiltless in the great accounting. Be not hesitant, therefore, to unfold the radiance of your love, for each of you, seekers of light, have much love to give, else you would not be on the path. The process of blending the outer consciousness with the inner is one of the great joys of my being. I am vitally interested in training these recalcitrant outer selves in the processes of thought and feeling, just as you would be interested in molding the consciousness of a small child. And here let me say that if there were intelligent direction of the child's actions and reactions before that little one had to meet outer world conditions, I firmly believe that the constructive pulsations planted within the consciousness would be stronger than the massed pressure of the conditions of Earth. But this is an aside from the point, a mere thought for the day, let us say. There are several doors to an individual's consciousness, and one of the most dangerous is the outer mind, which is like a sensitive photographic plate. This outer mind constantly feeds the consciousness with truths, half-truths, and with utter folly. This outer mind is an instrument provided by life by which the Holy Christ Self was meant to direct the process of evolution. It has become so gross and dense that the vibrations from the Presence and the Ascended Masters do not always record upon it. Yet the outer discordant suggestions from the visible and invisible are constantly recorded therein, which set up a condition of turmoil and distress in the outer consciousness. One simple way of knowing which force is using the outer mind is the test of feeling. If the I Am Presence, the Higher Self, the Ascended Masters, angels, or nature devas are playing on the mind, the feelings will be peaceful and relaxed and full of goodwill, and the consciousness will absorb that state of ascended master consciousness, and they will become one. When the outer mind is unhappy, rebellious, critical, and distressed, the consciousness is absorbing a separate entity and is being fed by destructive suggestions. Be ever alert, dear ones, to the protection of the mind from the danger of unseen forces. Man has no concept of the power of his own individuality to maintain an identity amid the thousands of tons of swirling energy that flow constantly in the lower atmosphere of Earth. Yet from that tiny stream of electronic force that flows into the human's heart and animates his body, there is enough pressure of light to keep even the unawakened man prompted from within to a point where he is enabled to pursue, even though slowly, the natural course of his evolution. This is one of the great miracles of evolution. Seen with the inner eye, humanity's evolution on Earth may be compared to a person swimming against the tide in a sea filled with all manner of voracious creatures, yet having within himself a tiny motor that would enable him to pursue the course toward his goal in safety. As the individual begins to awaken to the divine verities, the pressure of his own divine Christ nature increases, and the electronic light it generates flows through him so powerfully that it gives opportunity even to the most stubborn and ungoverned individual to rise out of the mass consciousness of the human mind, wherein is born all trouble and distress, thus enabling him to express his true God identity. I can sympathize with you, beloved wayfarers, because I have not forgotten the agony of spirit which I too suffered during my own earth journey in trying to manifest that sweet presence in an unbelieving world. My love enfolds you and strengthens you, each one, as you call to me for assistance on your homeward journey.
Lovely. Thank you so much, beloved Terry. God bless his mighty, beloved ascended ones. Right, so now we're going to move over here. All right, so this I thought was a good thing to read. This is from beloved Zarathustra, and I know we did read from something from him last week, I think. But without enthusiasm, nothing can be accomplished. And as we know, beloved Zarathustra is the God of enthusiasm. And he says, without enthusiasm, Jesus would have abandoned his ministry. In Gethsemane's garden, facing death, it was enthusiasm and fire that helped him to hold the vision that life is triumphant and that death, in truth, had no reality. Enthusiasm carried those blessed feet over the road to Calgary and held him upon the cross at Golgotha. Those of you who desire to build a foundation upon which a new age shall stand, those of you who profess to lay the cornerstone for freedom, I say to you, couple your vision with enthusiasm and use me as yourself. The fires of enthusiasm are not the fires of the zealot, the fanatic, which burn to ash and destroy. Enthusiasm is balance. Enthusiasm is positive and conscious progression, but the feeling is always under the control of the presence of God. Enthusiasm is contagious, even as is doubt and fear. Be careful, that which you carry in your feeling world, for contagion through the feelings has been the destruction of every golden age, as well as the foundation of every magnificent spiritual and physical perfection. If we did not have feeling to which we could tie, which could stir the masses out of the lethargy, we would not have sustained the planet to this day. So there it is. It's always, I think, really important to have that enthusiasm in each one of us to keep on keeping on. And now we have this wonderful opportunity, as we do always, to make the call for those ones that have left their physical bodies and are caught in the psychic and astral realm. So we say together, beloved presence of God, I am in me, and beloved immortal threefold flame of eternal truth within my heart, and beloved Saint Germain, while my body sleeps this night, let all the constructive energy of my entire life stream, including that in my causal body, be used to render whatever service is needed in the violet flame temples established in the psychic and astral realms, to draw the full gathered cosmic momentum of the violet purifying flame of divine love and compassion through every discarnate life stream there. Let all the souls who dwell in those realms be drawn into those purifying temples of mercy and compassion, and there have the accumulated destructively qualified energies of their life streams purified and transmuted, so that when they are summoned for re-embodiment by the Lords of Karma, they bring into incarnation only a heritage of perfection and carry in their life streams no miscreations that would add to their own or the world's distress. We accept this done now with full cosmic power. And so be it. Beloved, I am. Oops, someone unmuted there. And we thank you, and so it is. Thank you, thank you. Okay, this is absolutely beautiful. It's just the bird kingdom. They are so beautiful. Somebody sent this to you on, I think it was a Telegram group, but I think you'll enjoy it.
Mm-hmm. sueño un horizonte falto de palabras. En la sombra y en tres luces todo es negro para mi mirada. Si tú no estás junto a mí, aquí tú en tu mundo, separado del mío por un abismo. Oye, llámame, yo volaré a tu mundo lejano. Por ti volaré, espera que llegaré, mi fin de trayecto eres tú. Para vivirlo los dos por ti, volaré por cielos y mares hasta tu amor, abriendo los ojos por fin. Contigo viviré. Cuando estás lejana sueño un horizonte falto de palabras, y yo sé que siempre estás ahí, ahí, una luna hecha para mí, siempre iluminada para mí, por mí, por mí, por mí. Por ti. Espera que llegaré, mi fin de trayecto eres tú, contigo yo
vivo. Oops, it does always end abruptly, those TikToks. So it's just so beautiful, and that marvelous voice, that beautiful music, just so lovely. I thought that was really heart opening. As we know, the birds were originally created by the ascended masters as messengers, but they weren't ever created as vicious or as predators. So, that only came after the fall of man, but the beloved birds are just so beautiful. So we say together, beloved, I am presence of all mankind. Charge your mighty light of mercy and compassion to flow through us all and bring comfort to the animal, insect, and reptile kingdoms. May each human being remember and accept their responsibility as guardians and protectors of this planet's pure and innocent life until all is set free and their divine plans fulfilled. We so decree it and so be it. In God's most holy name, I am. We accept it done, and we thank you. Thank you, thank you. Now I'm going to read from, okay, I hope. All right, so this is lovely, the divine compliment of beloved Archangel Gabriel. And she says to us, oh, lovely ones, let us now go into the garden of God's heart, from which eons ago we lovingly permitted the beings who were to be the godparents of a system to come and select whatever flowers they decided to use in the plan of creating a planet. And in the necessary process of choosing the individual suns who were to bring forth the planets under their jurisdiction, many beings who carried a momentum of particular virtue were summoned so that the plan would mature as they saw it in God's heart. One of the many virtues which are activated at this time, hope, which is my great privilege to embody. The flame of hope is nurtured in the heart of the silent watcher of the planet, in the heart of the guardian of a locality, an individual life stream, the divas of the nature kingdom, and so forth. I am here today to accelerate the radiation of the holy essence of hope, held in the heart of your own Holy Christ self, that golden being who is increasing its sphere of influence within you daily through the flame of harmony, which is being so abundantly released by the beloved Lemuria. Since every being in heaven's realm embodies harmony, you can realize to a degree how the elder brothers and sisters are enthusiastically and lovingly enfolding you in their embrace so that this virtue will grow within you. You, an individual flower from the heart of God, are due to bring forth your full potential and take your ordained place in the kingdom of heaven. And that is possible while yet wearing a physical garment. We continually counsel you to be the Christ in action so that no imperfection will come forth during the resurrection period. The Christ or golden being is within your heart, and the time when it may step forth or take control of your vehicles depends on the purified condition of those garments. It has been brought to your attention many times that the physical vehicle is the expression of that which is pulsating within your etheric, mental and emotional garments, that your physical form reflects what is within the other lower garments, remembering the words of the Master Jesus when he said, "Be ye perfect." The most important reflection with which you should be concerned is the picture which you present to life. Be not dismayed at the reflection of another individual. You do not know what may surface from your inner garments. Can you honestly say or feel that you are an example to the Christ, of the Christ, to which your fellow traveler can look, and know that there is a chela who is proving the law? I do not chastise. I'm here today to assist you to accept the flame of hope as a tremendous factor in the transformation or transfiguration of the human into the divine. So there we have it, beloved Archei Hope. And there we're constantly being sort of prompted and prodded to move forward and become our Holy Christ self in action. And before John takes over, we're going to sing, because I thought it was pretty apt to sing to the beloved seven archangels. It's just lovely. Lovely. Bless the beloved archangels. And now John will take over from us. Thank you, beloved John.
Thank you, beloved Antia. and for all the gems that you have brought forth tonight. Now we say together, Mighty I Am Presence, great host of ascended masters, archangels and Elohim, cosmic beings in great cosmic light, come forth now in all your cosmic power. Withdraw and withhold all power from destructive forces and individuals with destructive intent throughout the world, right now and forever, whether it is conscious or unconscious. Expose, seize, bind, and render helpless all these sinister forces and their activities until the light has removed them completely, and illumine the source so this may never act again, and raise up to positions of power the divinely chosen leaders. Replace all with ascended master consciousness and the divine plan fulfilled. We thank you. Our tube of light protection. Beloved Mighty I Am Presence, beloved Archangel Michael, and beloved Commander Conrad, continually intensify your protective pillar of pure light substance and Archangel Michael's armor of light through and around me, charged with your invincible protection, all-powerful and impenetrable. I am invisible. I am invincible. I am invulnerable to anything but thy almighty perfection. I am grateful we are given whatever added protection is needed, and what we ask for ourselves, we ask for our loved ones, and that which is constructive in all mankind and the world. Thank you. We take some time to visualize, to see and feel this mighty tube of light from our mighty I Am Presence. This tube of brilliant crystal and blue light surrounding each and every one of us. That light that instantly deflects anything not of the light. See it now around our homes, families, loved ones, around this group gathered here this evening. See it blazing brightly around every person across the face of the earth. God bless, direct, perfect, and protect each and every one. Thank you. Our Violet Fire Decree. Mighty I Am Presence, beloved Saint Germain, and those that minister to the Violet Flame, come forth now and blaze your cosmic violet fire and cause a mighty victory for all the world to see. I am the law of forgiveness in cosmic action now. I am the victory of the sacred fire in all its cosmic power. Mighty angels descend with your purple ones of fire and strike them into the center of every place where there has been a history of sinister force activity. Transmute and consume it all. Cause, core, record, effect, and memory, and set it all free from that which was never meant to be. Place it all with ascended master consciousness and the divine plan fulfilled. We thank you. Thank you. or decree for the elementals. I am the light of God that never fails, purifying, loving, thanking, and blessing the great directors of the elemental kingdom and every beloved earth, water, air, and fire elemental for your ceaseless service to me and to all mankind. I am the mighty cosmic light, awakening all mankind to the great intelligence of this kingdom. And so be it, beloved I am. We thank you. In the name of my mighty I Am Presence, great cosmic beings and great cosmic light, I decree, I am the presence charging the minds and feelings of everybody in America and the world, with Saint Germain's ascended master consciousness and perfection, right now and forever. I am the presence blessing, illumining, perfecting, and setting all free in service to the light. Beloved cosmic I Am Presence and great goddess of liberty, direct the cosmic light of liberty as of thousand suns into the cause and core of anything attempting to delay the divine plan of the great white brotherhood for the earth's eternal freedom, and release us from all tyranny here and now. So be it, beloved I Am, we thank you. Our decree for divine justice. I am the most intensified cosmic action of the flame of divine justice, blazing throughout the world, right now and forever. I am the law. I am the justice. I am the judge. I am the jury. Knowing that I am all powerful, then I know that only divine justice can be done everywhere, here and now. Beloved Lady Portia, ensure divine justice prevails throughout the world, right now and forever. So be it, and so it is, and it is done. Beloved I Am, we thank you. Now, before saying our final decree, we call to you, beloved mighty victory. We demand mighty victory's heart flame become a garment about us, become a wall of invincible protection around us, become illumination within us, become all of everything we require to produce victory, everywhere, forever. We say together, I am the victory of the light. I am the victory of the light. I am the victory of the light. I am the cosmic flame of victory, which reigns supreme everywhere, right now and forever. We accept these wars answered as they are made, according to thy will, with full cosmic power, maintained and doubled each instant of each hour, until fully manifest. And so be it, and so it is, and it is done. Beloved I Am, we thank you. As we end off, we call to the secret love star. We feel that wonderful feeling of divine love as we make our calls to the secret love star, that tremendous focus of cosmic divine love from the great central sun, shining in the heavens for this 2,000-year period. Supreme light that can never be requalified by human thoughts or feelings. By the power of our beloved mighty I Am Presence, we say to all human creation, all misqualified thoughts, feelings, and actions, you have no power. You have no power. You have no power. Your end has come. By the power of our mighty I Am Presence, we invoke those pink and golden rays from the secret love star, and we command that they go forth, saturating all life on this earth, and that substance from the secret love star, that supreme light that pushes out all imperfections, all limitations, all inharmony of any kind, and fills every cell, atom, and electron of our four earthly bodies with those feelings of love and adoration, of peace and harmony, of gratitude and reverence for life, of kindness and tolerance, of charity, of grace and goodwill, and of comfort. Those feelings of unity and brotherhood, one holy family. Beloved secret love star, make each and every one of us a living sun of pure divine love, a radiating scent of pure unconditional divine love, so we may bless all those we interact with, every place we visit, and whomever we pass by. We send our deepest love and gratitude to the mighty beings of light who have maintained and sustained this great focus of love. We are most grateful. We give deep, deep thanks for this and the opportunity of adding our light to these calls. Thank you, beloved I Am. Thank you, everybody. Blessings to all.
Okay, marvelous. Thank you, beloved John. Bless your heart. All right, so just thinking now, who would like to read the... Morel, beloved, would you like to read the closing invocation?
Yes, thank you, Anthea. I'd be very happy to. Thank you. Beloved I Am Presence and beloved Master Kuthumi, nourish the seeds planted in my consciousness so that the ideas entrusted to me become manifest flowers of perfect expression in my world and the world of all my fellow men. Beloved Presence of God, I Am, pour the light of thy great glory upon my consciousness and nourish the seeds planted by the masters. We thank you.
Thank you, beloved Morale. Lovely. And so there we have it. Let's just take a moment, just open our hearts and just send gratitude and love to our I Am Presence, to the great ascended hosts, and particularly to Archangel Gabriel and all the great archangels. And just for all life that serves us as we walk our earthly journeys, just deep, deep gratitude for these marvelous teachings. Thank you, everybody. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to stop the recording now.